Okay, everybody, it's time to quieten down. The longer you take to quieten down, the longer it's going to be until it's the drinks. So I'd encourage you to settle quickly. We've now established the Homelessness Achievement Awards as a regular thing in our conference, where we celebrate our services, we celebrate our people, and we award a small handful of people, but in doing so we recognise that we're actually celebrating all of us and the hard work that we do every day, trying to end homelessness for people one person at a time, one family at a time. This evening, to MC those awards, because you know it used to be done by me, and I don't know, people used to find it somewhat soporific, and you know, that the look longingly at the door hoping for a drink, but I don't think that's going to happen tonight. And it's my pleasure to introduce nationally renowned comedian Sammy J to take us through the awards.
Thank you so much. If I see one of you looking at the door thinking of a drink, I will be furious. And if I see one of you looking at me as if I am acting in any way soporifically, I will also be angry. I am so delighted to be here. My name is Sammy J. Thank you for inviting me to this wonderful event. We live in a wonderful country with many notable deficiencies, and so my hat goes off to every single one of you for your efforts. I'd like to sing a song that I proposed to the federal government as a potentially alternative Australian anthem. They're yet to get back to me. On a hot summer's night, 'neath the Southern Cross star, I saw a young man being thrown from above. He violently vomited, fell to the ground. Then out of his mouth came a beautiful sound. He said, "Aussie, Aussie, Aussie, oi, oi, oi. Aussie, 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 oi, oi, oi." Many years passed, then I heard it again. On a beach in St Kilda one sunny weekend, I grew here, you flew here, I heard a man say, and as he was choking on capsicum spray, he said, "Aussie, Aussie, Aussie, oi, oi, oi." And the cops replied, "Aussie, Aussie, Aussie, oi, oi, oi." An elderly woman was teaching grade ones. She longed to retire but hadn't the funds. "There's only one lesson I'll teach you," she said. "Build up your super." And then she dropped it. And the children sang, "Aussie, Aussie, Aussie, oi, oi, oi. Aussie, 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 oi, oi, oi." A man sits alone on an island offshore. He's been there for years and he'll be there for more. And each night before bed, he looks up at the sky and he asks what went wrong. Then he hears our reply. We say, "Aussie, Aussie, Aussie, oi, oi, oi." And he whispers, "Aussie, Aussie, Aussie, oi, oi, oi." There are 200 countries, so I'll never know if my one is better than all of them, so I'll just go with the crowd and I'll be a good boy. And if someone says Aussie, then I'll reply, "Oi." This curious, cryptic, hypnotic refrain, "Oi, oi, oi." I don't know what it means, but it helps ease the pain, "Oi, oi, oi." So next time you're feeling lonely or low, "Oi, oi, oi." Just say the word Aussie three times in a row, then go oi, oi, oi. Thank you so much. Now, I heard someone just 20 minutes ago suggesting that we should encourage humour, the arts and levity, and I slipped that kind lady $50 afterwards because it was the perfect segue into how on earth I would arrive on stage after such a meaningful day. But I do think you've been through a lot today. It's been some wonderful stories that have been shared, some wonderful plans that have been made, and I think really the best possible way of seeing in the fabulous awards that we're about to head towards is by a bit of yoga. So everyone, standing up! Let's do it! On your feet, Melbourne, I'm not joking. Okay. Let it all out. I know you're all dignitaries and professionals who are earning more than I'd ever dream of, but let's just let it all out, okay? Okay, I'm gonna warm up first of all. Some nice little circles on our cheeks, okay? Come on, it's a Monday in Melbourne. We can do this together. At this point, I just want to point out this is not a cinema. I can actually see you. So if you're not taking part, I will come and get you, okay? Nice little circles. Okay, we're going to do a little bit of housekeeping yoga, okay? Because we want everyone to pay attention for the awards. So we're going to start with our first move, which is holding our phone up in the air and switching it to silent. Mime phones are okay, that's all right. Okay, if you're really feeling really daring, you might even like to turn your phone off. No one's going to call you in the next hour. Nothing important's going to happen, it's okay. Okay, our next move now is to point out the toilets, which are, of course, out that door. Some of you appear to think there are some out that way as well. Look, God help the kitchen sink, okay? Okay, and of course, if you do find yourself in the foyer going to the toilet, you might be stuck with some awkward small talk. So moving into our awkward small talk now, just turn to the person next to you and saying, "Oh, it was a nice day in Melbourne today. What a surprise." Very good. Okay. Hey, keep centered. You're doing really well, but this is not a joke, okay? So just remember to breathe, okay? Okay, now. Okay, that was... Are you mocking me, madam? Everyone else, hold your pose. What's your name, my friend?
Simone.
Simone? You're in the front row, you must be important.
Not at all. No.
You're invisible. Okay, well, not to me. I'd like you to participate. Freely. So, Simone, on your own. Phones off. Toilets. Awkward chit-chat. Okay, thank you, Simone. Now, we did all miss a move, of course, because before we go to the toilet, we might have to awkwardly leave the auditorium. Okay, so everyone on your tiptoes, and with me, excuse me. You're doing great. I like you a lot. Okay, and now, because we are a community of, I'm just going to go out there and say it, you're all bloody good individuals, okay, with big, full hearts. So we're going to get our community spirit on now. I want you to hold hands with the person next to you. Oh, now you're not so much into community, are you? Feel that repulsive touch of a fellow human on your skin. Disgusting. And we're going to send a nice, big, supportive wave right across the room from this side to this side. Okay, arms up. There we go. Okay, more of a static tsunami, but that's all right. Okay, and back down. Okay, and giving yourselves a round of applause as you sink back into your seats. Well done. Well done, everyone. Excuse me, I'm still here. Don't just talk amongst yourselves. We can stop that music now. I think we're relaxed enough. Thank you so much. If I can get quite a bit more keyboard in the fallback, that would be marvellous. I had such a lovely moment on stage just then because I had a flashback during our yoga performance, which you all performed beautifully, with one exception. I remember the last time I was in this building was actually for the Liberal Party campaign launch back in May. Oh, it was a riot of a time. I do a weekly political sketch for the ABC, and I think just before the election, like so many people, I had prejudged the outcome of the election incorrectly, so I thought I wouldn't get into trouble if I forged a pass and jumped on stage just before Scott Morrison started speaking. It's amazing what you can get away with a laminated lanyard in this building. They really let you go anywhere. Anyway, it was fun on the day, but I'm in the bad books in the Prime Minister's office. I'm also in the bad books with my wife because of the song that I'm about to sing. I wrote this some years ago after our second daughter was born. I didn't give birth to the second daughter, my wife did. I just stood idly by and had a mochaccino. It was very hot, I remember. It burnt my lip. It was really painful, actually. It was bad. The nurses were completely indifferent to my suffering. But anyway, it became apparent to me shortly after our children were born that life is, of course, somewhat changed forever. So I wrote this song and I sent it out to some friends as a bit of a farewell. This is a letter to all of my friends, the ones without kids, the ones who continue inviting me out on a Saturday night, then put up a fight when I don't turn up for the 50th time in a row. 'Cause I don't say no, I just say I'm really hoping to make it, which isn't a lie, but actually I know that there's no chance in hell that I'll be there. 'Cause I've tried before and it wasn't pretty. Stayed out till four, got a cab from the city, threw up in the laundry, crawled into bed, woke up at five with a foot in my head. It was my daughter asking for breakfast, and oh God, you've never had a hangover quite like the one that's accompanied by Peppa Pig. And I want to say thanks for inviting me. Your inclusivity warms up my heart. But our friendship is begging for clarity, so now it's up to me to say what I should have said at the start. I'll see you in 17 years. I'll be fine, go on without me. Don't look back, I don't want you to see me like this, holding a baby and covered in piss. Yeah, I'll see you in 17 years. Till then, just assume that I'm busy. While you go out clubbing, I'll be at home scrubbing the blueberry porridge out of my MacBook Air. Now I'm not complaining, I made my choice, and I'd rather be home than out losing my voice singing Total Eclipse of the Heart, which, as you well know, is what I like to sing when I'm drunk. But now I just sing it as a lullaby, rocking my daughter to sleep in the night, and I know she'll say thanks when she's older. Thanks for not being an absent father, and I'll say you're welcome. Happy 18th birthday. Now if you'll excuse me, I've got some friends I wish to see. So I'll see you in 17 years. Till then, just pretend that I'm dead. Picture my smile, remember my face. I'll be gone for a while, but save me a place till I see you in 17 years. Maybe less if my kids run away. And it'll be just like the old times again, except for the fact we'll be middle-aged men, and there's nothing as sad or as creepy as grown men reclaiming their youth. So pour me a bottle of vodka and tears, and I'll drink it in 17 years. Thank you. Thank you so much, my friends. You know when you agree to host an awards ceremony in the name of a wonderful cause with a group full of wonderful, supportive individuals, and then you don't quite realise that you can't do that when you're wearing tights and a singlet? We've all been there, right? Now, I secreted some clothes just here, and there is simply no unawkward way of doing this. So with your support, I'm going to do a reverse striptease, and accordingly, it will be the least sexy thing you've ever watched. Put It On has been the best heckle I have ever received in my life. More clothes-based heckles, please. Who wants to see me put on a shirt now? Ladies? Look, I could have chosen a different profession, and I could not be now experiencing one of the least dignified moments of my life, but I'm doing this for you, so you don't have to look at these little chicken arms for the next half hour during the awards, okay? I'm going to change careers and go to Crown Casino and become an actual stripper. How about that, okay? Now I'm just going to get my jacket, and as soon as I get my jacket, we are going to begin some official proceedings, because I'm having a lot of fun up here, but I think it's going to be more fun when some of you are rightly recognised for the work that you do. Give me a round of applause if you were nominated today for... No, don't... Oh, you were so attentive, you didn't let me finish before giving... Good on you all. Give me a round of applause if you're in the running for an award right now. Incredible. I'm just going to segue right over here now. Hey!
The other, yes, indeed.
Okay. I've just been fired. Have a great time. So Damien has advised me we're going to stand over here instead. I'm in your hands. I bought my own portable lectern, as we call it in the biz. Okay, now that you can all excise the image of my body from your brains, can I have a round of applause as we begin the Victorian Homelessness Achievement Awards for 2019? There will be no more nudity, and may I say sincerely, I was so honoured to be asked to come and take part in today's event, so thank you once again for having me here. You will find, I won't rabbit on too much during these awards, because you will find all the information on these awards in the program for the conference, and the information is also available on the awards section of the conference app, which I saw as being used before, which was fancy. We didn't have apps like that back in my non-existent career in the sector. award winners today will receive a framed copy of the artwork Yelka Yabini Wali, or Hawks Healing the Cuckoo Spirit Bird. This beautiful work was created by Yorta Yorta man Morgs and purchased through The Torch, which works with incarcerated Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people using art to facilitate cultural learning. You can read more about this artwork in your awards program. When I announce the winner, if you are lucky enough to be a winner today, I encourage you to please come on stage, collect your award, and have a photograph with lovely Jenny Smith just here, and then make your way back to your seats, or sneak off for a drink. And me, I don't think they want me in a photo, judging from the way they looked at my ribs before. It was we're all recovering from that moment. I went too far. Leave jacket on, okay. Oh dear. Please, some decorum. I'm genuinely excited about our first award, which is the Award for Excellence in Ending Homelessness Among Children and Families. This award recognises programs, organisations or partnerships that have made an outstanding contribution to ending homelessness in Victoria for children and families. Our nominees for this award are the Salvation Army for the Family Violence Transitional Management Initiative, Uniting VicTAS for the Housing, Education and Linkage Program, Haven Home Safe for Moving On, the Statewide Children's Resource Program, Melbourne City Mission for Vicky's Place, and St John of God Healthcare for the Young Mother and Baby Program at Horizon House. Round of applause for all the nominees. And the winner is Melbourne City Mission for Vicky's Place. Vicky's Place is a refuge in northern Melbourne for young women and their children who are experiencing homelessness, escaping violence and managing other complex issues. It supports its clients with housing and personal needs and has a major focus on child-led therapeutic practice through tailored case plans, early intervention and activities like music and animal-assisted therapy.
Congratulations to Vicky's Place. Great news.
Thank you so much, Molly. The next award is the Award for Excellence in Ending Homelessness Among Young People. The nominees for this award are Launch Housing for the Education First Youth Foyers in Broadmeadows and Glen Waverley, Melbourne City Mission for Front Yard, Barwon Child, Youth and Family for the Geelong Project, a community of schools and services, Anchor Inc. and Hams Group for Hazel Hams Homes, which is very fun to say, Anglicare Victoria for the Home Stretch Campaign, Homey, Hope Street Youth and Family Services, NISAE, or Northeast Support and Action for Youth, and the Salvation Army for the Upton Road Accommodation and Learning Centre. And the winner is Barwon Child, Youth and Family for the Geelong Project, a community of schools and services. Congratulations. The Geelong Project is an innovative place-based community of schools and youth services early intervention program that works with young people from the most disadvantaged schools in Geelong who are at risk of becoming homeless and or disengaging from school. It has attracted national and international attention for its approach and strong early results.
anyone does win an award and doesn't want me to ruin their photo, don't worry, I'm leaving enough room for you to crop me out later on, okay? We now move to the Award for Excellence in Ending Homelessness Among Adults. Our nominees for this award are Wishin, Moss, Vincent Care, the CHP PESP, and DHHS for Anish, A New Approach to Single Households. Melbourne City Mission for the Atrium Housing and Support Program. Haven Home Safe for the Hayvan and Hay Ute Mobile Assertive Outreach Program. DPV Health for HARI, or Housing Advice, Referral and Information. Macaulay Community Services for Women for the Macaulay House Integrated Service Model. Vincent Care Victoria for Quinn House. And Tenants Victoria for the Tenants Victoria Rooming House Outreach Program. The winner is Macaulay Community Services for Women for the Macaulay House Integrated Service Model. Congratulations. Macaulay's model of integrated accommodation and support has been designed to meet the multiple complex needs of women who are homeless and unwell, and draws on 30 years of experience. Providing safe and stable accommodation in houses in Footscray and Ballarat, it also tackles complex legal, health and financial issues that can prevent transition into stable new lives. Feels like the Logies, but far classier, I gotta say. We now move to the last award for excellence, the Award for Excellence in Ending Homelessness Among Diverse Groups. A range of communities are overrepresented in homelessness, and this award seeks to recognise those achieving excellence in ending homelessness for these client groups. This might include excellence in addressing homelessness for people who identify as LGBTQI, people who are culturally or linguistically diverse, Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander people, or older people. And the nominees for the Award for Excellence in Ending Homelessness Among Diverse Groups are Baptcare Sanctuary Uniting and Brigidine Asylum Seeker Project for their program Housing for People Seeking Asylum, the Pride Foundation Australia initiated and University of Melbourne led LGBTI Housing and Homelessness Projects, Vincent Care Victoria for their LGBTIQ work, NEMI National, the Victorian Aboriginal Health Service, Uniting Care Region and Northern Area Mental Health Service for Wadumba Willem, and Women's Property Initiative. And the winner is Vincent Care Victoria. Vincent Care launched a comprehensive review of its site, systems, programs and practices to identify how best to support LGBTIQ clients and maximise their housing outcomes. Acting on that review has resulted in rainbow tick accreditation, leadership in the sector, an increase in referrals of LGBTIQ clients from other organisations, and positive feedback from clients.
Listen, we're absolutely delighted to get this, and it really does represent the work of all of the staff at Vincent Care. It has been an extraordinary effort led by Jack and many, many other people, and we do want to acknowledge that while this has been absolutely transformative for us as an organisation, and it has meant so much to so many people, at its heart has been creating what you keep saying to me, Jack, is a culturally safe space within the organisation for people, for queer people, and for a culturally safe space for clients who are queer and identify a range, a whole spectrum, and it's been incredibly important. And I also want to acknowledge that we as an organisation have done damage to your community and over many, many years, and often in the name of doing good. And we come to this and the ongoing journey of continuing to be inclusive with a great degree of humility and with an awareness of the fact that we as an organisation, while we have made great strides, there's still a long way to go. And so, and if any of you guys are thinking of chasing and going after Rainbow Tech, I really, really encourage you to do it, not only because it's the right thing to do for our clients and for staff who are members of the LGBTI community, but also because it will be transformative for your organisation. I am amazed at what this has done for us as an organisation. Thank you for having the courage, to you and to all of our staff who are members of the LGBTIQ community. You've been generous with your advice. You've been generous with your life experience, and you've led us in an extraordinary way. And it's great, with great humility, that we're here, and it's fantastic to be recognised for all of that hard work. And thank you to you, to Lisa, who's now at the Salvos, but to your leadership and to the generosity of all staff who embraced this. Thanks. I think it's time for me to get off.
No one wants to follow such a gracious, beautiful, humble speech. That was amazing. Congratulations and thank you. We now move to the award specifically for individuals. The first award recognises a leading practitioner making a difference in the lives of those experiencing homelessness. This award recognises leading practitioners in the homelessness sector who go the extra mile and keep consumers at the centre of their practice. The following outstanding nominees are passionate advocates for consumers and work with consumers to create individualised responses rather than requiring individuals to simply fit available response offerings. And the nominees are Catherine Dyer, a rooming house outreach worker at Tenants Victoria; Maddie Cooper, senior youth outreach worker at Melbourne City Mission; Margaret Thorpe, manager at Sacred Heart Community with Sacred Heart Mission; Natalie Bonfer, who delivers the Housing and Education Linkage Program through Uniting Wyndham; and Pip Elsie, the Keeping Home Project worker at Beyond Housing. And the winner of the 2019 Leading Practitioner Award is Margaret Thorpe. Margaret is the manager at Sacred Heart Community, which provides a unique suite of aged care services for people who experience premature ageing due to homelessness, trauma and severe disadvantage. She steered SHC from being a low-care residential service to an award-winning resident-directed model, which now provides a home for life, including palliative care. Congratulations, Margaret.
A few words. Thank you to all the people who nominated me. I won't say any more.
Congratulations again, Margaret. The next award is the Consumer Achievement Award. Ooh. I hope you win, or that'll become a sad sound from that. It's an honour to be nominated. We all know that. This award recognises individuals who have experienced homelessness and made an outstanding contribution to improving the lives of others experiencing homelessness here in Victoria. The Consumer Achievement Award is sponsored by the Rotary Club of Melbourne. I'd like to invite James Puller on stage to represent Rotary Club of Melbourne and hand over this award. Please make James welcome. I've just had word that James was repulsed by my body during yoga and is currently hiding in the lower cabin of the Polly Woodside down by the Yarra. So we wish him well, and I will be visiting him personally to apologise. In the meantime, the nominees are Dylan Langley, nominated by the Create Foundation; Frank Otis, nominated by Unison Housing; Helen Matthews, nominated by Launch Housing. A lot of pressure on Helen now. And Sim Crawford, also nominated by Launch Housing. Oh, good, yes. Round of applause for all the nominees, please. And the winner of the award for consumer achievement, I'm relieved to say, is Helen Matthews. Helen has shared her lived experience of homelessness across Victoria on behalf of Launch Housing and Council to Homeless Persons. She's taken part in Q&A panels, media interviews and other speaking engagements, contributed strongly to policy development and participated in educational activities for the homelessness sector, libraries and local government. Helen will also be addressing the conference tomorrow, talking about her own experience with the NDIS. Once again, congratulations, Helen, for your award.
We're not quite finished, but one of the things we haven't acknowledged is that this judging was really hard, and it was done by a panel who gave themselves up to have to consider some really difficult dilemmas. So thinking Alan Martin, Rebecca Cleaver, Michael Fotheringham, Mary Riley, and just me. So it really is a very hard job, and it, on one hand it's really exciting for the sector that it's a really, really hard job, on the other hand it's just a really hard job. But back to
thank you so much. And now it is time for the last award of the early evening or late afternoon, the Beth Thompson Award for Lifetime Achievement. This award category recognises sector leaders with passion for creating exceptional responses to homelessness matched with dedication to those served. Over the course of their careers, these leaders have shown commitment and leadership in providing effective and empowering responses to homelessness in Victoria. This award is named in honour of Beth Thompson, who worked in the community sector for more than 30 years. Beth's work, yeah. Come on, bigger cheers. Beth's work provided vital services for a range of highly vulnerable groups, including young women with borderline personality disorders, people with HIV/AIDS, and young people experiencing homelessness. Beth served as the CEO of Wombat Housing and Support Services from 1995 through 2008. Beth was an inspirational leader in the broader homelessness service sector, where she was well known and respected by her peers as well as in government departments. In particular, Beth is remembered for treating people with dignity and respect and for her warmth and humour. The Beth Thompson Lifetime Achievement Award seeks to recognise these qualities, and we are very pleased to have Beth's family member, Sasha Sergi, here tonight to witness the presentation of this award in her name. Please make Sasha welcome as well. As Jenny just mentioned, the judges want to make particular note of how difficult this award was to decide this year. All five nominees exemplify Beth's spirit, her leadership, and her dedication to addressing previously unmet needs in the homelessness service system. They say it would have been an honour to award this award to any one of the nominees. However, they chose only one winner. The nominees are, and please let's give a hearty round of applause to each nominee, Brian Lippman of Wintringham. Karen Walker from Launch Housing. Kerry Ashley at Haven Homesafe. Mady Graham from Uniting VicTas. And Rita Lawrence at Merry Outreach and Support Service. And without any further ado, the winner of the Beth Thompson Award for Lifetime Achievement in 2019 is Brian Lippman of Wintringham. Angry and frustrated by the lack of options for frail and elderly people, 30 years ago, Brian became the founder and first CEO of Wintringham, which is recognised as a world leader in the delivery of housing and support to elderly people who have experienced homelessness. He's been awarded multiple honours for his vision, leadership, advocacy, culture of care, and influence. Once again, please join me in congratulating Brian Lippman.
Summary is that I've had a fortunate life. I've had an opportunity to live my politics, to work with some of the most inspiring people you could ever hope to meet, and some of the most fabulous characters that I've been blessed to meet. So thank you, Jenny. You do a magnificent job, as does CHP.
Congratulations, Brian, and that brings us to the official conclusion of these formalities, and that does mean that it is the official beginning of the drinks. Good times. I want to thank you once again for inviting me to take place. It is so lovely to be involved in an event filled with such warmth and generosity. I wish you all the very best for the rest of the conference, and indeed in the months, years ahead, I hope to see you throughout them. Have a lovely evening. Cheers.